Happy Tuesday! Uh-oh, 3 minutes after noon. Well, still, happy Tuesday morning, early in the day, and summer reading. And we know that we started off yesterday learning about Ezra Jack Katz, or Jack Keats. Ah! I had a Freudian slip because I called his name out, his old name. I told you that both of his parents were Jews and they faced a lot of anti-Semitism back in the 1940s, and so they were both, like I said, from Poland, and Ezra had a lot of talent. Well, he thought it was necessary to change his name, so his original name, yeah, very Hebrew Old Testament names, Jacob Ezra Katz. And then he changed it to Ezra Jack Keats. Isn't that something? A lot of people have changed their names. You know, Martin Luther King was actually Michael. And that's because his father was also Michael, and the father changed both his name and his son's name because of the teachings of Martin Luther. I think after a visit, I thought it was Mahatma Gandhi, but I might be mistaken about that. But anyway, this is a book by Ezra Jack Keats named Louis. And we know yesterday we were talking about Louis' search and how he gained a beautiful bonus dad. Barney, what's his name? Brandon Barney. But anyway, I saw this at the library and I said, oh my goodness, there were a lot of books that Ezra Jack Keats wrote on the same characters, right? Peter and the Snowy Day. You see some of the same people. Well, I said, let me delve into this Louis book and see what it's about. So this is, I'm sure, written before 1980. When he was around 64 years old. Let's see, this had to be in the 70s. 1975, yep. All right, so Susie and Roberto are putting on a puppet show for all the kids in the neighborhood. You know, those old fashioned, that's what I'm saying. You know, let's get these kids out and let them play these old-fashioned games outside, and maybe, you know, just in the backyard or in a safe place, but to get them off these electronic devices. So, puppet show for all the kids in the neighborhood. Louis, a boy whom none of the kids have ever heard speak, is so taken by the puppet show, by the puppet Gussie, that he jumps to his feet and stops the show by yelling, "Hello! Hello!" straight at the stage. In front of a hushed audience, Susie and Roberto have to figure out what to do. This classic Ezra Jack Keats, or Jacob Ezra Katz, story of love and generosity remains as fresh today as it was when it first appeared more than 20 years ago. Oh, honey, no. Almost 50 years ago. Yeah, 48 years ago. The harsh unloveliness of inner city streets is forgotten in the brilliant paintings which form a backdrop for a tender story of spontaneous unselfishness. Horn book. And we know that Ezra grew up in New York, in the Brooklyn area, and he grew up impoverished at times. His father, I believe, was a waiter, and his mom contributed to the family. All right. Susie and Roberto were putting on a puppet show. Now let's look at these beautiful paintings. Remember, Ezra wrote and illustrated. Wow, look at this. Susie and Roberto were putting on a puppet show. They had spent a lot of time making the puppets. Kids were trying to find seats next to their friends. Wow, everybody's here, said Susie. There's Louis, said Roberto. I never heard a word out of him. Me neither, said Susie. Well, let's get started. Look at this 1975 flair. the hats, the froze. It's just beautiful. I tell you. Look at that. The curtain opened. A mouse puppet appeared on the stage. The mouse introduced Gussie. When Louis saw Gussie, he stood up. Hey, sit down. We can't see you, Louis. We can't see through you. Come on, sit down, will ya? Right? No one broke out in fists and fighting. No guns were pulled out. No. Just said, hey, just come on, sit down, will ya? Louis just stood and stared. He was mesmerized. Remember, he didn't say anything before.
Oh.
And then he said, hello. More emphasis, hello. Yeah, his first word. Hello, hello. And now look at Louis. Whoa, look at them beautiful brush strokes. I tell you, this man was a masterpiece. Oh, now, oh goodness. This reminds me of a French painter. Oh, well, of course. Lautrec. Toulouse-Lautrec. There is a painting at the Art Institute that has the same type of shadows. Lautrec. Was a painter, and I remember Toulouse-Lautrec, he was stunted in his growth, like 4 feet tall, Toulouse-Lautrec, because I believe his mom dropped him. And oh, that reminds me of the story in the Bible, Mephibosheth, when the nurse dropped him. Well, anyway, it stunted his growth and he had some type of disease. I don't know if it was polio, but he didn't grow past 4 feet tall, but he found solace and an outlet in painting. And there he would a lot of times Moulin Rouge. He has a painting in Moulin Rouge, and he would paint nightclubs and all that. But anyway, there's a painting of him in a club, and if you look closely in a nightclub, he's a short man. And he painted himself into the masterpiece. But what I was saying is he is famous for shadows and so many multiple shadings and brushstrokes and impasto, where he layered so many of the hues. Look at this. He was intense. It's just so dramatic. This was a masterpiece. And this is 1975. My goodness. What's going on? Asked Susie. Roberto peeked over the stage. It's Louis, he whispered. He's talking to Gussie. He won't stop. This is in the middle of the puppet show. Well, what'll we do? Susie thought for a moment. We'd better have Gussie answer him. Oh, that's good. Hi, Louis, Susie said in Gussie's voice. Nice to see you. But me and the mouse gotta get on with the show. Will you please sit down? There's lots more to come. Louis sat down. The place got quiet, and the play continued. The kids laughed at the adventures of Gussie and the mouse. Look at the beautiful greens. Aww. When the show ended, the puppets bowed. Everybody cheered and clapped. Louis jumped up and clapped loudest and longest. Oh, he was excited. Yeah, you never know what will bring out a very quiet child. As everyone was leaving, Susie and Roberto saw Louis. Would you like to say goodbye to Gussie? Susie asked. Oh, that's so sweet. Louis grabbed the puppet and held on to it. What'll I do now? Susie whispered to Roberto. Gussie is very tired, explained Roberto. She has to go home now. Louis waited a minute, then let go of Gussie. Susie and Roberto started off. Louis waved until they were out of sight. You see how he grabbed? They really dealt with the situation very well. They used words They used empathy and compassion. This is what I'm saying. A lot of times when conflict arises with these kids, they don't use words. They're shouting, if you say one more thing, I'm going to. And we have to model compassion, patience, and words, language. Oh my goodness.
Oh, look at this.
This is a beautiful collage. Oh, this man was just a genius. Then he walked home. The height of luxury soars 46 stories. It's very interesting to see the words that artists choose to put in their collages.
1960 to Tuesday Cafe.
Or Tuesday. It happened to be Tuesday. Yeah. Ice cream cone. But he was lonely. He went into his room and sat on the floor. Oh, Louis, what's going on with you, buddy? I bet you this was Ezra in a way. You see his art? This is the way he expressed himself.
He dreamed he was feeding Gussie from a huge ice cream cone. What?
The ice cream cone looked yummy, yummalicious.
Suddenly, Gussie disappeared, and the cone too. Louis was falling down, down, down.
Now he was floating. There were kids all around. They were making fun of him. Hello, hello, nah, it's goodbye, goodbye. Oh yeah, hello and goodbye, Louis.
Louis,
or more so, Louis, his mother called. So you see that? You see the kids? Yeah, it can be very tough being a child right about now, being a teenager, being a young person. Louis. She called, Louis, what are you doing? He didn't answer. He was still sad from his dream. His mother went on, someone slipped a note for you under the door. It says, hello, hello, hello. Go outside and follow the long green string. Louis got up and went outside. Look at this, look at this. Composition, will you look at this? Door, the colors. Look at the steps, the porch. Banisters, look at this. This reminds me of Sesame Street now set. Oh my goodness. And where, yeah, Oscar the Grouch would have been. Look at this. Look at this brick wall. Look at the colors. Now look at how he's following a green stream. Oh, this is just so enjoyable. I'm sorry. Oh. Hello. Oh, look at the door. This is so beautiful. As a gift. That is beautiful. And that's it. Yep. Ezra Jack Keats grew up in Brooklyn and spent most of his life in New York. His many award-winning books include Snowy Day, Goggles, both Caldecott Honor books. And he's a great man. All right, let's be kind today and color someone else's world when they feel very rejected. Good day.